Have you ever wondered how to create the perfect pairing? I researched pairing and I stumbled into sensory science. In a sea of books, scientific publications, videos, podcast interviews, I seemed to find a missing piece of the jigsaw. So brought that together with the chemical basis of flavour. Some of the classic affinities that we take for granted, there's actually a lot more going on there. So let's dive into this just now. Hello, Hendo here, and welcome to What is Molecular Pairing? In this video, you'll discover a new way to look at your food and drink experience. To learn more about food and drink pairings, sensory science, and marketing with a global perspective, please like this video, subscribe, and click the notification bell to learn more valuable insights. Now, I've been talking about molecular pairing at events, live events around the globe, for nearly a decade, so I think it's probably about time that I explain things a little bit further. Breaking down the definition, molecular pairing, the two different words, molecular and pairing. So molecular relates to chemistry, specifically to molecules. A molecule is an extremely minute particle. Two or more atoms bonded together represent the smallest fundamental unit of a chemical compound. What we are interested in here are the volatile compounds that have smell or odour. These are like families grouped together. Aldehyde, esters, ketones, lactones, phenols. If you take phenols, for example, the medicinal aromas, but they can also be found in vanilla as vanillin. So it's very complex. These can be identified in the lab with gas chromatography, studied by scientists for research in disease and also for foods that we eat in flavourings. So if we take, for example, strawberry, there are thousands of versions of strawberry held by large food companies that have been manufactured for the supermarkets, from anything from the strawberry yogurt all the way through to shampoos. Now, pairing has a simpler explanation. It's a coupling of, a bringing together. So molecular pairing pertains to use chemistry as a way of explaining food and drink affinities, using the molecular basis of flavour, identifying aromatic volatile compounds both within food and drink, then seeking out the harmonies. Once you understand sensory science and how the brain processes this, we can now learn how to bring harmonies together, where there are similar compounds within the drink and similar compounds in the food. Distillers making Scotch whisky will test samples for high ester levels, and this can bring those rich dark fruit notes in the final spirit after maturation. So this is an example of building flavour. If you add to this the modern techniques of molecular cuisine, the modern cooking methods, for example, sous vide, meaning under vacuum, very precise temperature controlling to yield a certain texture, mouthfeel, flavour enhancement. It can heighten our taste perception and sensation of being luxurious. There is lots of science behind ice cream, for example, so you can adjust elements to explore texture, temperature, taste, and enhance certain aspects of the meal. Also remember, we have the cause and effect of the food and drink, the interaction between the five basic tastes. So that's sweet, salty, sour, bitter, and umami. Tell me in the comments what your favourite number one food and drink pairing is. Now, in respect to these basic tastes, if you look at different parts of the world, there's a different philosophy. So in the West, there's been more about affinity and harmony in the pairing of traditional cuisines, and in the East can be more colliding and clashing of these basic tastes. So there can be more Moorish new sensations, tantalising and addictive style foods that we love in things like Southeast Asian cuisine. So knowing the molecular ingredients of the foods and also of the drinks, taking them into isolation and understanding, like for instance, sherry cask whiskies have strong amount of eugenols in them, bourbon cask whiskies have many whiskey lactones. So this, you can then bridge across if you know that lactones are also in things like coconut and in soft fruits and what have you. So once you have this, you can start to build a picture of pairings, and very quickly you can create menus around this. So this molecular basis of flavour can provide explanation and the foundation of creative food and drink interactions. But it doesn't need to be super complicated, this molecular pairing. There are many pairings that are quite simple, but also unexpected pairings do appear as well. So it gives a bit of scope, something quite interesting, and also adds a little bit of storytelling to your experience. This is just an introduction, the molecular pairing, creating a series on this. So I'll link in some of the other videos here. And I've actually created hundreds of molecular pairings at events and dinners across the globe. Please tell us what you think of molecular pairing, this explanation. Is it a new experience for you? Have you tried these pairings at dinners and events? Really love to know what you think about this, your feedback. It's a subject that's close to my heart. I love chemistry and really enjoyed researching these for events and explaining and having sharing the stories around them. So it's been a pleasure, and hopefully I'll see you in the next video. Thanks very much for watching.